recognizing the power of the word as an instrument to promote and protect democracy, as well as our moral responsibility to promote and protect literacy and moral rectitude. In accordance and support of our most precious Constitution, we pledge that we, as citizens of these United States, in order to form a more perfect union, establish justice, ensure domestic tranquility, provide for the common defense, promote the general welfare, and secure the blessings of liberty to ourselves and our posterity. Swear to promote and protect what has been ordained and established as our Constitution for the United States of America, and as such, offer proof of our witness to our power of the word through the offerings of our work, in order to not only document for all conscious souls to experience, but leave an ongoing legacy, for our actions are the actions of the future. And as such, recognize this moment as sacred for the next seven generations. I'm gonna do something out of form, but I feel it has to be done. This is by Emma Lazarus. It's called The New Colossus. Not like the brazen giant of Greek fame, with conquering limbs astride from land to land. Here, at our sea-washed sunset gates, shall stand a mighty woman with a torch, whose flame is the imprisoned lightning, and her name, Mother of Exiles. From her beacon hand glows worldwide welcome. Her mild eyes command air-bridged harbor that twin cities frame. Quote, keep ancient lands your story pomp. Unquote, she cries with silent lips. Quote, give me your tired, your poor, your huddled masses yearning to breathe free, the wretched refuge of your teeming shore. Send these, the homeless tempest tossed to me. I lift my lamp beside the golden door. Emma Lazarus, 1849 to 1887. Continuing out of form, I wish to read something before we begin. This was written on the 19th of June. I won't even explain it, I'll just read it and you'll know exactly where I'm coming from. Some of you have heard it already. Faith-based, hanging on to every word from their orange Messiah as gospel. A dark comic genius setting himself on fire, seducing the media from day one, distracting as the mischief is in full press, packing the federal courts for life with like-minded right-wing arch-conservatives, maintaining the exact substandard to perpetuate lies, dismantling social programs, erasing humility, chloroforming humanity, subjugating women not to have control over their own reproductive rights, alienating allies, embracing tyrants. For us to be appalled by the present immigration policy separating children from parents who have illegally entered the country. Where is the action? Where is the protest? Why are the streets not full of, with indignation, placards, shouting and marching feet, disavowing any approval, any connection to this orange menace and pandering sycophants? This is an overt human rights violation, not rising up against only proves our continuing hypocrisy, our history's continuing hatred. We slaughtered the indigenous of the New World and defiled the pristine land through our self-righteous piety for God, glory, and gold. Millions died. We slaughtered our American indigenous, stole their land, and then the concentration camps of reservations, separating their children from their parents, putting them into orphanages, taking their language away, taking their culture away, all under the auspices of Christianity, punishing these children harshly if they didn't abandon who they were. And African slaves brought to the Americas from 1525 to 1866, affecting 12.5 million, where 1.8 million died in transit, 388,000 brought to the United States. King Cotton ruled the day, capitalism at its best, demonic indifference, rationalized through Christianity, leading to the Civil War, rationalized pro and con, killing 700 plus thousand of ourselves. And then, in spite of the January 1st, 1863 Emancipation Proclamation by Lincoln, slavery continued. Jim Crow, peonage, which affected 800,000 lives in the South for 80 years, finally ending December 12, 1941 by Roosevelt. But segregation continued, overtly in the South, covertly in the North. All the lynchings of African Americans, 4,400 in 12 different southern states from 1877 to 1950. All the photo ops by those who relished the event, making sure their face was clearly documented. Men, women, children, posing in their Christian righteousness, their specific communal piety. And then, concentration camps for our own Japanese citizens during World War II under Roosevelt. And now, slavery, regardless of race or sexual orientation, still exists. Too many still not given an even playing field. Opportunity, not a handout, but an environment so to self-motivate, an environment demonstrating the tools so to evolve, so to contribute to the greater good. This is a world of the deaf and blind, whose only interest is its own reflection, believing in one geopolitical God, the only way towards salvation, indifferent to truth and science, self-involved demagoguery, politically corrected beyond the enlightened of merit, relegated into numerical quotas of appearance and sexual proclivity. This fake news movement, beyond rendering us to not know what to believe, exhausting us into such extreme pacifism, succumbing to the special interests in financial control, total imperial power, solely predicated upon greed, hiding behind patriotism, perverting our most elevated utopian legal document, life, liberty, and the pursuit of happiness. An intellectual exercise created by the most incongruous of men, tearing it down at every opportunity through the courts, through what legislation? We did it. Unleashed the corporate banking oligarchy of military theocracy, constant war, constant surveillance, constant suppression, constant antagonism towards the unity of dignity, blurring what is most human when fighting for our rights with every psychotic nihilist anarchist who only wants martyrdom. Now, stealth is the ultimate freedom. Social media has opened the floodgates of chaos. Opinions like assholes. Everybody's got one. And AI is listening, documenting every transaction, every idea, every interest, every opinion, every titillation, surmising our motivations and outcome. America is dying. She is seriously, towards terminally ill. Poisoned by these very un-United States of united hatred and special interests. How can we possibly be moved by children separated from their parents when it is we who separated ourselves from the greatest utopian legal premise? Promise ever created. If America is allowed to perish through the wanton greed of the corporate United States, the lights will go out around the world. Material-driven fascism will be the striving impetus, whether from the boardroom or the individual. Soulless reptilian lust, impulse-driven, predatorially cannibalistic nihilism. Enough.